T Bank Easy Choice Checking Studio. Today's best variety. 93.7 WSTW.
The following message is being transmitted at the request of the Camden County Office of Emergency Management and the Cherry Hill Police Department. This is a reminder that the site of the former Subaru headquarters, located between Route 70 and North Park Boulevard in Cherry Hill, will be imploded today no earlier than 6 p.m. local time. Due to the size of the structure that will be demolished in the blast, it has been recommended to local residents that all individuals within a 5-mile radius of the location temporarily evacuate the area until the residual smoke subsides. This has been suggested by the mayor of Cherry Hill as a precaution for health and safety, as the building may or may not have asbestos or lead-based paint materials as part of its structure. A siren will sound in the area 15 minutes before the time of implosion, and once again 1 minute prior to the blast. Repeating, this is a reminder that the site of the former Subaru headquarters, located between Route 70 and North Park Boulevard in Cherry Hill, will be imploded today no earlier than 6 p.m. local time. Due to the size of the structure that will be demolished in the blast, it has been recommended to local residents that all individuals within a 5-mile radius of the location temporarily evacuate the area until the residual smoke subsides. This has been suggested by the mayor of Cherry Hill as a precaution for health and safety, as the building may or may not have asbestos or lead-based paint materials as part of its structure. A siren will sound in the area 15 minutes before the time of implosion, and once again 1 minute prior to the blast. Please stay tuned to local emergency alert system radio and television stations, and mobile devices equipped with wireless emergency alert system capabilities, for information about when it will be safe to return to your home or place of business after the blast.
Home, Megan.
They lift me up on their shoulders. And
first week back, people just said thank you.
Now what about the second week? A new generation of veterans is coming home. Make a difference.
Thank you.
The following message is being transmitted at the request of the Camden County Office of Emergency Management and the New Jersey State Police Department. This is not a test. Repeating, this is not a test. At about 6:05 p.m. this evening, a scheduled and previously planned demolition of the former Subaru headquarters took place in the town of Cherry Hill. After the implosion took place, it was discovered that one of the explosives to be used for the demolition had been replaced with a device that was nuclear in nature. It is with a heavy heart that I make the announcement that this device has been detonated and that a nuclear explosion has occurred in the town of Cherry Hill. To everyone receiving this message, please listen carefully to the following instructions. Number 1. Under no circumstances is anyone to approach or enter the town of Cherry Hill. If calculations are correct, everything within a 1 mile radius of the epicenter of the blast has been leveled. Number 2. If you are within 20 miles of Cherry Hill, you are being ordered to shelter in place. To shelter in place, go to the lowest floor of the building you are in, preferably a basement or cellar. Place as many solid objects between you and the outside world as possible. Bring enough food, water, medical supplies, and prescription medication to last as long as 2 weeks, alongside of a first aid kit, a radio or television that can be operated by batteries or hand crank, and a mobile device if possible. Sheltering in place is critical for this area, as nuclear fallout will be occurring within a short period of time. Fallout is a byproduct of nuclear explosions, which is spread through the air in particles that cannot be seen, felt, smelled, or tasted. Fallout may cause radiation sickness or death, and because of this, do not exit your shelters for any reason until told otherwise by civil authorities. Please take note that emergency services, such as law enforcement, fire departments and medical services, will be limited or in some cases, unavailable during the initial duration of this emergency. Please do not use the telephone lines, both cellular and landline, until further notice. These lines need to be kept open for official use. Please restrict all personal communications to text messaging or internet-based communication, if still available. If internet services are in fact still available in your area, please refrain from using it for non-emergency purposes. Data servers need to be kept available and open for emergency and official use. Number 3. Fallout is spread throughout large areas, mostly by means of the natural airflow within the atmosphere. The latest forecast from the National Weather Service in Mount Holly has the current wind direction as northeast, where it is expected to remain. If you are within 50 miles northeast of Cherry Hill, it is recommended that you follow the same shelter and place orders that were previously mentioned. If you are currently on the road and traveling in a northeastern direction away from Cherry Hill, it is recommended that you alter your direction of travel to a more direct eastern or western location to promote a safer recovery area. In all situations, do not exit your shelter for any reason until an all-clear message is given. In the event you no longer have access to a radio, television, or mobile device, the all-clear message will also be announced by means of a steady siren notification. As previously mentioned, it is being calculated that all areas within a 1 mile radius of the epicenter of the blast has more than likely been leveled due to the explosion. For those living outside of this immediate location, that have loved ones that would have been in the area at the time of the blast, the mayor of Cherry Hill had previously suggested that people vacate the area prior to the blast, due to potential pathogens in the building's structure. Because of this, many people had left the area, which may have reduced the number of fatalities in this horrible event. Please withhold trying to get into contact with family, friends or loved ones at this time, as once again, communication lines need to be kept open for emergency use. If you have family in a school, hospital or nursing home, remember that such facilities have their own emergency plans and are being taken care of to the best of their ability. While we are currently unaware of who, how, or why this explosion took place, at this time we are considering this to be a terrorist attack until additional information can be confirmed. If anyone in the public has any information about the situation, we are urging you to call the New Jersey State Police at 800-555-6573. That's 800-555-NJPD. All persons with information shall be kept anonymous. Please only call this number if you have details about the whereabouts of who is responsible for this explosion. Any non-essential calls will be automatically terminated. In the meantime, please remember that we are all in this together. We all ask that you remain as calm and collected as possible. Remember that panicking will only make your situation worse. We will continue to give the public updates about this terrible situation at regular intervals around the clock at 12, 3, 6, and 9 a.m. and p.m. on all emergency alert system television and radio stations, including the station you are currently listening to or watching. Mobile devices will also be sent updates at these same times if your device is equipped with wireless emergency alert system capability and if you have government-issued messages turned on. We hope to have more information about this terrible tragedy in upcoming hours and days. Meanwhile, please take care of yourself, and we thank you for your cooperation. May God bless you all.
The following message is being transmitted at the request of the Camden County Office of Emergency Management and the New Jersey State Police Department. This is the official October 9, 6 a.m. update to the aftermath of the nuclear explosion that occurred 9 days ago in the town of Cherry Hill. At this time, radiation levels continue to be at a high enough level that sheltering in place is still required. Do not leave your shelter for any reason, as the risk for severe radiation poisoning is still highly probable. Emergency services, including law enforcement, fire departments and medical services are still only available on a limited basis, and should only be requested in the event of a life or death situation. Radiation levels are presently being checked throughout the Quad State area, and such levels are beginning to subside in areas southwest of Cherry Hill, to the point where shelter-in-place orders may be lifted within the next 24 to 48 hours in those areas. This includes the following counties. In New Jersey, Western Burlington, Western Camden, Cumberland, Gloucester, and Salem. In Pennsylvania, Chester, Delaware, Lancaster, southeastern Montgomery, and southern Philadelphia. In Delaware, Kent and Newcastle. And in Maryland, Cecil. Based on current radiation levels, areas to the northwest and southeast of the town of Cherry Hill are expected to have their shelter-in-place orders lifted sometime between the next 72 and 96 hours. This includes the following counties. In New Jersey, Atlantic, southeastern Burlington, eastern Camden, Cape May, and Southern Ocean. And in Pennsylvania, Berks, Bucks,
Carbon, Lehigh, Monroe, Northwestern Montgomery, Northampton, Northern Philadelphia, and Pike. Areas northeast of the town of Cherry Hill are the most affected and continue to have the highest levels of radiation. Due to these higher than acceptable levels, these areas will most likely not have their shelter in place orders lifted for at the very least an additional 5 to 7 days. This includes the following counties. In New Jersey, northeastern Burlington, Hunterdon, Mercer, Middlesex, Monmouth, Northern Ocean, Somerset, and Union. In another update, the New Jersey State Police is still looking for additional details of who may have been responsible for the nuclear detonation that occurred this past September 30th. If anyone has any information on the whereabouts of the person or persons that may have had a connection with this potential attack, please contact the New Jersey State Police. Their number is 800-555-6573. Once again, that's 800-555-NJPD. Please note that all individuals that provide authorities information will be kept anonymous for their protection. The Camden County Office of Emergency Management and the New Jersey State Police will continue to provide updates at regular intervals at 12, 3, 6, and 9 a.m. and p.m. on all emergency alert system radio and television stations. Details will also continue to be provided on mobile devices that are equipped with wireless emergency alert system capabilities. Your local governments thank you for your continued cooperation.
The following message is being transmitted at the request of the Camden County Office of Emergency Management and the New Jersey State Police Department. This is the official October 14, 9 p.m. update to the aftermath of the nuclear explosion that occurred 14 days ago in the town of Cherry Hill. All clear. Repeating, all clear. Radiation levels have been checked within the last 3 hours, and levels are now appropriate for leaving your shelters in the following counties. In New Jersey, Burlington, Camden, Hunterdon, Mercer, Middlesex, Monmouth, Ocean, Somerset, and Union. These are the final counties in New Jersey to receive an all-clear message. Before exiting your shelter, please listen carefully to the following information. The epicenter of this nuclear explosion was located in Cherry Hill. While previously speculated, it has been confirmed by local law enforcement that the entire town of Cherry Hill has been leveled and destroyed. At this time, anyone caught walking around the town will be arrested for trespass, as the area is currently considered to be too dangerous for exploration. If you are a resident of Cherry Hill and need information on a plan of action, You are asked to call the Camden County Office of Emergency Management at 856-555-2236. That's 856-555-CCEM. Please call this number prior to returning to the area. If necessary, collect calls will be accepted. In addition, it should be noted that while an all-clear announcement has been made for your area, most public services, including law enforcement, fire departments and emergency medical services, may be unavailable or restricted. You should expect to not have full access to such services for at least 5 to 7 days. While the 911 phone system has not been compromised, citizens are asked to only use the number for life or death situations only. If you have a concern that is not life-threatening, please call the non-emergency number. For police, the number is 856-555-1000. For medical assistance, call 856-555-0911. This is a reminder that the New Jersey State Police is still looking for details of who may have been responsible for the explosion that took place this past September 30th. If anyone has any potential information on who may have been responsible for the nuclear detonation, or the whereabouts of the person or persons that may have had a connection with this explosion, you are being urged to contact the New Jersey State Police at 800-555-6573. That's 800-555-NJPD. All individuals that provide information will be kept anonymous for their protection. Repeating, all clear. Repeating, all clear. Radiation levels have been checked within the last 3 hours, and levels are now appropriate for leaving your shelters in the following counties. In New Jersey, Burlington, Camden, Hunterdon, Mercer, Middlesex, Monmouth, Ocean, Somerset, and Union. While previously speculated, it has been confirmed by local law enforcement that the entire town of Cherry Hill has been leveled and destroyed. At this time, anyone caught walking around the town will be arrested for trespass, as the area is currently considered to be too dangerous for exploration. Most public services, including law enforcement, fire departments and emergency medical services, may be unavailable or restricted. You should expect to not have full access to such services for at least 5 to 7 days. While the 911 phone system has not been compromised, citizens are asked to only use the number for life or death situations only. Your government thanks you for your cooperation during this difficult time.
Unleash your creativity and dot your world. Right, sold separately.
Coming up next, enjoy the rest of your weekend. KYW News Time, 5 o'clock.
All news, all the time.
KYW, KYW HD, and 94.1 WIP-FM HD2, Philadelphia.
KYW News Radio, 1060.
This is KYW News Radio 1060, a CBS radio station serving Pennsylvania, New Jersey, and Delaware.
Give us 30 minutes, and we will give you the world. This is Saturday, October 31st, 2020. Coming up this half hour, in politics, with just days before the 2020 presidential election, will Pennsylvania remain a red state as it did in 2016, or will it revert back to blue? We have your opinions. In technology, Microsoft has announced delays with their new and upcoming Xbox models. What does this mean for Sony PlayStation users? And checking sports, in our two-part special report, attending live sporting events in a COVID-19 world. Will this become the new normal for years to come? Part 2 of this series coming up later this half hour. Currently, it's 65 degrees at our studios on Market Street in Philadelphia. I'm Kristopher Christman. KYW News Time 5:01. In the news this hour, we have the first reports of a developing story regarding the individual responsible for the massive nuclear explosion that happened on September 30th, which destroyed the entire town of Cherry Hill in New Jersey and left over 15,000 people dead. The explosion, which occurred at the site of the former Subaru headquarters in Cherry Hill, was a planned demolition by means of implosion. However, after the process began, it was discovered that one of the explosives had been switched out with a nuclear device. The New Jersey State Police has learned new information about the person involved in this situation, in which an arrest has been made. 32-year-old David Johnson, a former employee at the Subaru plant, was apprehended at his Wilmington, Delaware home earlier this afternoon. According to police, they were given an anonymous tip to Johnson's whereabouts early this morning. Upon his capture, Johnson pleaded with police not to harm him and confessed to the crime. Johnson mentioned during his capture that he blamed COVID-19 for his actions. In a statement released by Cherry Hill Mayor Sean Devlin, Johnson stated, quote, "I just couldn't take it anymore. I had lost my job several months ago. In the middle of a pandemic. I was ineligible for unemployment. I couldn't even get a censored stimulus check. Meanwhile, the company I worked for was getting bailed out by the same government and was even rumored to be upgrading to a bigger and better facility. Yet I couldn't be a part of it after 12 years of service. I wanted people to pay, but in the end too many people paid. More people paid than should have." End quote. According to authorities, a quick scan of Johnson's computer indicated that he had been communicating with individuals on the dark web who had provided him with recipes for a homebrew nuclear device. KYW had attempted to reach out to the head of the former Subaru headquarters, however it was discovered that he was one of the over 15,000 people that perished in the blast. "We have also reached out to the regional manager for more information. We will have updates as the day progresses." Johnson is currently being held at the Howard R. Young Correctional Institution in Wilmington, with no opportunity for bail. The trial is scheduled to begin sometime in November. KYW News Time 5:03. With just a few days away from Election Day of 2020, many residents of Pennsylvania and around the country are making the final preparations to place their vote in this historical presidential election. While many people have already casted their ballots via mail, sitting President Donald Trump is confident that states that swung from blue to red will remain consistent.
Thank you.